In this example, we're asked to find the arc length of f of x equals 2/3 x cubed plus 1 over 8x between x equals 2 and x equals 6. So we have a formula for the arc length, and it looks like this. The integral from a to b of the square root of 1 plus f prime of x squared dx. So then to begin, we should probably find our first derivative, f prime of x. So f of x is 2/3 x cubed plus 1 over 8x, and I'm going to write that as 1/8 x to the negative 1. So then, if I find my first derivative, I'm going to get 2/3 times 3 x squared plus 1/8 times negative 1 x to the negative 2. Okay, so then if I clean that up a little bit, that's 2x squared minus 1/8 x to the negative 2. Now this derivative, this expression, is a little more complicated than the one we looked at previously. So let's actually work on squaring it before we plug it into our integral. Do our work out to the side here. Okay, so I want to square this expression, which means I'm going to have to FOIL it. Okay, so if we work that out then, it looks like we get a 4x to the fourth, and then minus 1/4 x squared x to the negative 2, and then minus another 1/4 x squared x to the negative 2, plus 1 over 64 x to the negative 4. Right, x to the negative 2 times x to the negative 2 is x to the negative 4. So then I've got 4x to the 4th minus, I've got two similar terms here, right, both with coefficients of 1/4, so it's going to give me minus 1/2. If I combine those, right, 1/4 plus 1/4 is 1/2. But then what do I have here? X squared times x to the negative 2. Well, that just gives me 1, right? This is essentially x squared over x squared. So just minus 1/2. And then plus 1/64 x to the negative 4. So now that we have that, let's go back and set up our integral. So our bounds are from x equals 2 to x equals 6. And then under the root, I have 1 plus this expression I just found. So 1 plus 4x to the 4th minus 1/2 plus 1 over 64 x to the negative 4th. Okay, so under the root, I've got this 1 minus 1/2. So if I combine those, this becomes 4x to the 4th plus 1/2 plus 1/64 x to the negative 4th dx. Now, I should note that in general, these arc length integrals are extremely difficult or often impossible to evaluate in closed form because of the square root, right? The square root makes it very difficult to evaluate these integrals. And this one's pretty messy, but actually I have picked a special case to show you, and we can actually evaluate this integral with a little bit of algebra, and maybe some algebra that you haven't seen in a while. So, out to the side here, I just want to remind you of a fact. There is a special form called a perfect square trinomial. Something that looks like this: a squared plus 2ab plus b squared factors into a plus b quantity squared. And actually we have this form here. Okay, so let's try to prove that to ourselves or make sure that that's true. So this first term here, so I have, I've got 4x to the 4th plus 1 half plus 1 over 64x to the negative 4th. Okay, so I can write that as 2x squared quantity squared. And let's leave off that middle part for a second. And this last term I can write as 1/8 x to the negative 2 squared. So then I see my first and last terms are definitely something squared and something squared. But for it to be a perfect square trinomial, that middle term has to be 2ab. So let's see if that's true. So 2 and a looks like it's 2x squared, and b looks like it's 1 over 8 x to the negative 2. So does that equal 1 half? Well, I've got x squared, x to the negative 2. Those cancel the 1, and then it looks like I've got 4 over 8. So yes, this is a perfect square trinomial. A very carefully selected problem. So then I can factor this into a plus b quantity squared. So then this equals 2x squared plus 1/8 x to the negative 2 quantity squared. And you could check that by FOILing it out, and you should get back to our original expression. So then let's get back to our integral using what we just discovered. So underneath the square root, then I'm going to write this as quantity 2x squared plus 1/8 x to the negative 2 squared and dx. So now what we have is we have the square root of something squared. So we can reduce that, and what we'll end up with is actually the absolute value of this expression here. So I've got the absolute value of 2x squared plus 1/8 x to the negative 2 dx. Still between 2 and 6. But let's look at this expression here a little closer. So I've got 2x squared plus, another way I could write this is 1 over 8x squared, right? So this is actually positive. For any x value, right? Because I've got this x squared on top in my first term, and then I've got this x squared on the bottom here. But any x that I plug in, x squared is going to be positive. So this is always positive. So then actually I don't need to worry about those absolute value symbols. They would be redundant in this case. So then what I have is the integral from 2 to 6 of 2x squared plus 1/8 x to the negative 2 dx. And I can actually integrate this expression pretty easily. So if I find the antiderivative, I get 2x cubed over 3 plus 1/8 x to the negative 1 over negative 1. So 2/3 x cubed minus 1 over 8 x evaluated between 2 and 6. So then of course I just plug in my bounds. So if I plug in 6, I get 2/3 6 cubed minus 1 over 8 times 6 minus, and then I plug in 2. So 2/3 times 2 cubed minus 1 over 8 times 2. And you can plug that into your calculator and get a more simple numeric value. But I'll stop here. So this is our arc length in this case. And once again, this is a really special case where I just happened to be able to do some algebra tricks to evaluate the integral. But in general, it often happens that this integral cannot be evaluated, or at least not with the techniques that we've learned so far. We'll learn a few techniques a little bit down the road that might help us in some cases to evaluate these integrals.